Hello, church family. Pastor Danny here. I just want to share with you three quick things the Lord has placed in my heart to share with you today. As we approach to a new season, what looks like new change is coming via new social norms and expectations, I believe more now than ever we need to begin to rebuild our walls, begin to prepare our hearts for what God is calling us to for this season. We've all experienced challenges and obstacles these past few months, but I believe there's something greater on the horizon. It sort of reminds me of the story found in Nehemiah where they were rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem. They had just returned from exile and the walls remained unprepared. This made them vulnerable and weak. In a season where it seems like we were at constant battles in our faith and it could take a hit, our prayer life can become apathetic or our devotion can spread thin. I want us to be in a place spiritually where we are ready for what God has in store. As we begin to open churches, go back to workplaces, see friends and neighbors again in person, of course practicing social distancing, I want us to be ready to spiritually to receive and answer the call God has placed on us, to reach the lost, to preach the gospel, heal the sick, and be a light to this world. It doesn't mean we've stopped doing that, but it does mean that there are some areas where we need repair. What are some areas you are needing rebuilding right now in your life? Is it your prayer life, your devotional life, scripture reading? Is it evangelism or serving? What is God calling you for this season? Have you asked or taken the time to consider or even ask? God, what is it that you have in store for me, for my family this season? Where are some areas that I need repentance from or areas that I have let slide? Now is a great time to reevaluate, repair, restore, heal, and prepare our spirits for what's coming. Nehemiah prayed and sought God. He was ready to heed God's calling in his life and lead others as well. He spent intentional time in prayer, acted upon it. I want to read and pray this over you today. Listen to what Nehemiah says in chapter 1, verse 5. He says, Lord, the God of heaven, the great and awesome God who keeps his covenant of love with those who love him and keep his commandments, let your ear be attentive and your eyes be open to hear the prayer your servant is praying before you day and night for your servants, the people of Israel. I confess the sins we Israelites, including myself and my family's family, have committed against you. We acted very wickedly towards you. I have not obeyed the commands, decrees, and laws you gave your servant Moses. Remember the instruction you gave your servant Moses, saying, if you are unfaithful, I will scatter you among the nations. But if you turn to me and obey my commands, your exiled people of the farthest horizon, I will gather them. And there they will bring them to a place I have chosen as a dwelling for my name. They are your servants and your people, who you redeemed by your great strength and your mighty hand. Lord, let your ear be attentive to the prayer of this servant, and to the prayer of your servants who delight in revering your name. Give your servant success today by gaining him favor in the presence of your son. And that's so encouraging to hear Nehemiah praying this over his people, saying, give your servant success today by granting him favor in the presence of this man. Three things I want to leave with you. The first thing is prayer and action go hand in hand. Trusting God means to be proactive, engaging, and moving. We don't just pray and sit back and wait for something to happen. Instead, we continue moving forward, walking in faith. We look for opportunities to arise, doors to open, or trust the Holy Spirit is guiding us as we step out in faith. We can only do that when we have prepared our spirits to receive what God has. That means repairing or rebuilding parts of our lives that need work, need attention. Prayer for discernment when lately probably all that we've done is trust in our own understanding. Secondly, plan according to God's plans and not your own. Pray according to his will and not your own. How that looks like is seeking his word, his promises. What it is that he's showing you, speaking to you, teaching you, or the word or the thing or even person he has placed on your heart. For Nehemiah, it was to physically rebuild the walls and lead his people and uniting them to complete this task. For us, it can be preparing our spirits for the harvest of lost souls that's to come. Thirdly, prayer. Pray for results. Put the results in God's hands, and that's what prayer does, because all you're doing is saying, God, hey, I'm trusting in you. Be obedient. He blesses and honors those, and you will see the victory come out of it. Prayer is putting it in God's hands and not my own. It's saying, watch what God can do when we pray. It's saying, watch and witness his power. Church, are you ready for what's to come? Are you prepared spiritually to jump into what God's calling you for this next season? Or do you need to repair some areas right now that maybe you've let slide a bit? Be encouraged that it's not too late. If you watch this video all the way through, that's a start. Continue moving forward, continue seeking after his presence, and begin to be renewed and come out of the season stronger than how you entered before. God is not finished with you. Amen. Be blessed today.